Dear viewers, welcome to this lesson on angle properties of circle for A-level mathematics. This is our fourth and last lesson on angle properties of circle. I am Dr. Angatia from the MIE. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to solve problems involving tangents and their properties on circle. So let us now explore the properties of tangents on circle. So this is a circle with center O, radius OI or OJ. Now we have a tangent here, IC, which touches the circle at I here. So I is known as the point of contact where the tangent touches the circle. We have another tangent here, JC, which touches the circle at J. So this is another point of contact where the tangent touches the circle. Now these two tangents meet at C. This is known as the external point. Also, observe that the distance from the point of contact to the external point, in this case, it is 162 millimeters. So they are both equal in length. So these two tangents, the distance from the point of contact to the external point is equal. Now we consider the angles between the radius and the tangent at the point of contact. So we can see that in both cases, the angle is 90 degrees. And this is true for any tangent and any circle. So the tangent of a circle is perpendicular to the radius and the point of contact. Now, chord and segment. Now, IJ is a chord and OC is a segment joining the center to the point of, to the external point. So we can see that the angle between these two segments is 90 degrees, and also OC bisect the chord IJ into two equal parts. In other words, OC is the perpendicular bisector of IJ. This is a very interesting result. So we can see this is true for any external point and for any circle. So we say that OC is the perpendicular bisector of the chord IJ. Now let's have a look at the angles, angle at O and angle at this external point. So we know that O, I, C, J is a quadrilateral. The sum of interior angle is 360. Now these two angles being 90, they add up to 180. Therefore, The sum of these two opposite angles is 180. So let us verify. So angle C here is 70 and here it is 110. So 80, 100, sum is 180, 90 and 90, sum is 180. So it is now at C it is 30 and at the center it is 150. So the sum is still 180. Let us vary the circle now. So we have 160 and 20. So we can see that this is true, 170. And here it is 10. So we can see that these two angles are supplementary. That is, their sum is 180. So sum of angles O and C is 180. Now we have angle bisector. So this line segment cuts this angle into two equal parts. So we can see that the angle is 120. And now we have two angles of 60 degrees. And they are always equal. So the segment OC bisect the angle at O and also the angle at C. So this line bisect the angle at O and angle at C. Also we can see that these two angles, they are equal and equal to 90. Therefore, these two triangles are reflection of each other in the segment OC. So this figure is symmetric about OC. So segment OC, this segment, bisect angles at center and external point. So this segment bisect the angle at O and the angle at C. Now we consider angles at O and at these two points, I and J. So we see that they are equal. They are equal. So these two angles are equal. These two also are equal, but they are equal among themselves. So these four angles are equal. And now we can see that this is 26, 26 here. So these two angles are also equal. So this one is 26. Now this angle is 90. Therefore, this angle is 180 minus 90 minus 26, we have 64. But consider this triangle now. If this is 26, 90, therefore this is 180 minus 90 minus 26, we have the same angle, which makes sense. Again, this triangle being right angle here, this angle 64, 90, and the difference is 26. So this resembles a kite, which is symmetric. And we have equal angles. So we will now work out some questions on these properties. Example 1, find the unknown angles, part 1. Now, here we have a circle with two tangents, AB and CB, or tangents, whereas OA and OC are two radii. We know that angle between radius and tangent at a point is 90 degrees. Therefore, A is equal to 90 degrees. Radius is perpendicular to tangent. We also see that B, radius tangent, so B also is 90 degrees. Radius is perpendicular to tangent. Therefore, if OABC is a quadrilateral, these two angles add up to 180. Therefore, these two angles will add up to 180. So what is C? 180 minus 50, which is 130 degrees. So angle C is equal to 130 degrees. Now, part 2. Here we have a circle, center O, radius OA and OC. We have an external point here, B. So AB and CB are tangent. So this angle is 90 degrees. These angles are 90 degrees. So what is angle E? Angle E is equal to 90 degrees minus 25, which is 65 degrees. Now, we know that OB bisect angle AOC. So angle F is equal to angle E, is equal to 65. And as OB also bisect ABC, D and 25 are equal. Therefore, D is equal to 25 degrees. So, part 3, we have a circle, center O, we have AB as tangent and CB as tangent. Now, we know that this angle is 90 degrees, and then we need to find H. So what is H? H is equal to 90 degrees minus 20 degrees, 70 degrees. So we know this is 70 degrees. And we also know that G is equal to 20, or we can find it other ways. So we can consider this triangle. This is 90 degrees. That is, this is 90 degrees. So to obtain G, we can take 90 minus 70, we obtain 20. So G is equal to 20 degrees. Now, we know that OB bisect this angle. So I is equal to H. Therefore, I is equal to 70 degrees. And J is equal to G. So J is equal to 20 degrees. We also know that K is equal to I, K is equal to 70 degrees, or we can consider this triangle. We know that this is 90 degrees. We also know that this is 20 degrees. So we have 20 here, we have 90, so this is 90 minus 20, which is 70 degrees. Now we consider part 4, we have circle with center O, we have AO radius, OB radius, OD radius, we have BC as tangent and DC as tangent. So here the unknowns angle are P, Q and R, but OB is a radius and BC is tangent, So this angle is 90 degrees. So what is P? It is 90 degrees minus 30. So angle P is equal to 90 degrees minus 30 degrees, which is 60 degrees, because angle B is equal to 90 degrees. I mean, this is 90 degrees, this one. Now we know P is 60. And we know AOC is a straight line, so this is 120 degrees. And we also know that ABO is an isosceles triangle because AO and OB are radii. Therefore, these two angles, they are equals. So we have 120 here, so R is equal to 180 minus 120 over 2, so we take 60 divided by 2, we have 30 degrees. So R is equal to 30 and Q is equal to 30 degrees. But we also know that this angle is equal to the sum of these two angles. So we could have divided 60 straightforward by 2 to obtain R and Q. So again, so here P is 60, R is 30, and Q is 30 degrees. So we move on now to question 2. Question 2, we are given here tangent AB, which is 8 centimeters in length. We are given radius OA, which is 6 centimeters, and we're told that OB is equal to X centimeters. So find angle, find X. X is a length here. X is a length, but we know that radius and tangents are perpendicular. So therefore, triangle OAB is a right angle triangle. Therefore, we can apply Pythagoras theorem. So using Pythagoras theorem, we know that hypotenuse to the square is equal to AB square plus OA square. So we know that X square is equal to 8 square plus 6 square. So we have 64 plus 36 is equal to 100. So we have X square is equal to 100. Therefore, X is equal to square root of 100. So we consider only positive square root of X here because length cannot be negative. So we move on now to our last example, example 3. So here, find DAB. Find DAB. So we need to look for this angle. So let us see what information do we have. So we have AB, tangent. We have OA, radius, so we know this is 90 degrees. Now, OAD is an isosceles triangle because OA and OD are radii. So this is a straight line, so 140, this one is 40 degrees, so is this one 40 degrees, therefore this one must be 50 degrees because we have 90 minus 40. So let us write down the answers. So we know that angle ODA, ODA is equal to 180 minus 140, which is 40 degrees. Why? Because ODB is a straight line. So this is 180 degrees. We also know that OAD is equal to 40 degrees. Why? Because triangle OAD is isosceles. We also know that tangent and radius are perpendicular. Therefore, we have DAB is equal to 90 minus 40, which is equal to 50 degrees. Why? Because radius is perpendicular to tangent. So angle DAB is equal to 50 degrees. To sum up, in this lesson, we solve problems involving tangents and their properties on circle. Here are the links of the GeoGebra tools developed and used to explore angle properties in the four lessons. I hope that you enjoy the lessons. Do share them with friends. I thank you for your attention. Goodbye.